Welcome to this segment of You'll Love Where We Take You. I'm Edie Bornstein, Vice President of Sales and Marketing for Azamara Club Cruises. Today I'm taking you there from Ho Chi Minh City, also known as Saigon, Vietnam. I'm in front of the Cu Chi Tunnels, and this is just one of 187 ports in over 60 countries around the world that Azamara Club Cruises can take you to. Come cruise with us. Bon voyage! This amazing itinerary takes us away for 14 nights from Hong Kong to Singapore to discover Vietnam and Thailand. I'm here with our destination expert, Claudius Dosakau. Hi, Claudius.
Hello, Edie.
This amazing itinerary begins in Hong Kong. What do you suggest our guests see and do in Hong Kong?
I would probably recommend, and I'm sure you will disagree, that our clients arrive 1 or 2 days early to see Hong Kong, Victoria Peak, the night market. But we have delayed our sailing from the ocean terminal in Hong Kong to about 8:30 in the evening because, as you know, Edie, at about 8 o'clock there is the famous laser show over Hong Kong Harbor, and it's just a spectacular sight to be seen nowhere else in the world.
I couldn't agree more, and not to mention, I do agree with a couple of days prior because you have to fit in all that bespoke shopping that you can do in Hong Kong. So once we leave Hong Kong after the laser light show, which is magnificent, we have an at-sea spa day before we get to Ha Long Bay, which is Hanoi, basically, in Vietnam. And we're there for an overnight. What do you suggest our guests see and do in Hanoi, Vietnam?
As Edie mentioned, Ha Long is the port city for Hanoi, the capital of Vietnam. And I highly recommend that our guests consider the overnight trip to Hanoi because maybe contrary to popular belief, the old French colonial part of Hanoi was not destroyed during the war. And it's just a wonderful place to experience Hanoi and to explore, especially in the evening. And then the next day, drive back down to Ha Long and maybe take a cruise on one of the Chinese type of junk boats and sail through the magnificent islands.
Wonderful. From there, we go to Da Nang, still in Vietnam. What do you suggest our guests see and do there?
As our ship moves down the coast from the north of Vietnam down to the central part of Vietnam, where you find Da Nang at the very near to the old demilitarized zone, there are many, many options to choose from on this particular full-day tour. How about a bike ride through the UNESCO village of Hoi An, or if you're interested in history, drive to the old imperial city of Hue, and then there is China Beach and the Marble Mountain. So plenty of options to choose from.
Wonderful. From there, we continue on with an at-sea spa day before we get to Ho Chi Minh City, which when I was growing up was called Saigon, for an overnight. What do you suggest our guests see and do in Saigon, Vietnam?
Because of the size of our ship, we are actually able to sail up the Saigon River to less than a mile walking distance to downtown Ho Chi Minh City. And it's a very convenient spot for our clients. Not only to take in some of the many sites, but I would recommend our guests definitely consider a trip out to the Cu Chi Tunnels. And in the evening, I like to head out to the Rex Hotels, the rooftop bar, and have a cocktail or two, and then maybe take in Vietnamese dinner at many of the very excellent restaurants.
Very nice. Then we continue on with another at-sea spa day before we get to Bangkok, Thailand, where we're actually docked for 3 days. What do you suggest our guests see and do in Bangkok?
That's right, Edie. That day at sea between Ho Chi Minh City and the 3 days in Bangkok will be much enjoyed, I think, by our guests. I would recommend that our guests, because of the long stay in Bangkok, take our excursion over to Angkor Wat in Cambodia. It's very convenient. The flight from Bangkok to Angkor Wat is only 1 hour. And I have to say, and I'm sure you agree with me, that Angkor Wat is at least as magnificent to see than the Great Wall of China. So it's a wonderful sight. And by taking that overnight trip to Angkor Wat, you will still be left with enough time to see the temples and the palaces of Bangkok and, of course, try some of the famous Thai food.
Sure. From there, we head out for 2 days at sea and 2 spa days at sea as a result, before ending up in Singapore. Now, I love Singapore. I think it's a beautiful, beautiful place. And I was just curious, what do you like to see and do when you're in Singapore?
I think, again, once I suggest that our guests extend maybe about one or two nights, because as you said, Singapore is a fascinating city and many things to do. Maybe visit the, as you have just recently seen also, the New Sands Resort Hotel with its very unique design and poolside, rooftop poolside. But also there's the Raffles Hotel, famous for the Singapore Sling. In the evening, you might want to go to the zoo, which has a very interesting program there at night. The Botanical Garden is very famous. And I particularly like to go to some of the food stalls. Superb food, very clean, and excellent to try.
Well, all a wonderful way to make your way from Hong Kong to Singapore. Whether you take this Oz Amazing Departure or any of the others that Azamara Club Cruises sails to, for sure, you'll love where we take you. Come cruise with us. Bon voyage!